It's no secret that the Lae City Council and the Lae Urban Local Level Government are not in good financial standing. Both organizations are terminally ill, financially incapacitated by 20 years of mismanagement. And that mismanagement has been public knowledge when the investigation reports of the abuse were made available in 2017. For the LULLG, it owes hire car companies up to 20 million kina. And today at this public forum between the Lae MP, council officials and councilors, there was more bad news.
You mean LCA is just collecting your money to make sure that you've got money you're spending? Where were they the last 30 years? All now fix it or something? 2 years and we fix it over something? Where were they? The workers, do you know that you are owed over 4 million kina? The council has cut your money, not only Bengal or PSF. Do you know PSF is going to garnish all your council accounts? Do you know that the IRC is going to garnish all your accounts? The dinner of the council now standing is 27 million.
Immediately after being elected, John Rosso brought in investigators from the Intergovernment Relations Department, and they found widespread instances of corruption and abuse. He also pushed through a legislation to establish the Lae City Authority. Then, through a ministerial directive, he sought to plug the theft within the council.
Because long outstanding issues surrounding two plus governments, a government long local level government, Lae City Authority, services.
The ministerial directive gave permission for the Lae City Authority to collect and hold revenue in trust. But that move that has the support of the chairman of the LCA and the Lord Mayor James Kay has faced a lot of resistance from within.
Society line or top management been sitting here for ages now. Still they cannot do enough now. Collaborate corruption now. All this stuff's stagnant. I don't need them. I want the PA to take all of them back to the provisional administration pool. Now I want to put the position to advertise the position, and then get good people to work with me to talk about the betterment of our city.
The basic idea explained in this morning's meeting was to manage the existing revenue streams better, grow the funds, restructure the council, and improve the basic delivery of services in Lae City. It's simple yet difficult for many of those within the already collapsing system. The risk of not addressing the outstanding money owed to the IRC and the superfunds are serious.
If it's not dealt, they shut down all the accounts that belongs to the council. And it is by law that the IRC and the superfunds are paid.
Scott Wade, National MTV News, Lae.